welcome to part 2 of the LED panel light project. With the frame built and the panels mounted, it was time to start connecting up. I began to realise that I might want some control over how much light I was getting, and I couldn't use a simple dimmer as the LED power supplies would try and push 284mA, regardless of the input voltage. If I thought about this at the beginning, I'd have made the frame an inch wider to accommodate some switches, but it was too late for that now. So I decided to go for a remote switch box. Off camera, I made a bracket to attach a cable, added cable ties, and then fitted it to the frame. Then I prepared some 12-way mains rated cable and attached it. For safety's sake, I was going to need a terminal cover. I got an empty serial box and roughed out a template. Then I cut the cover from thin polycarbonate sheet. Using some junk that I had lying around, I knocked up a prototype folding machine. It's a bit basic, but it did what I needed to. I can see it has potential, and hopefully I'll find time to make a Mark II using what I've learnt along the way. Once it was folded, I fitted the cover in place. I could have bought a box to put my switches in, but I reckoned I had 3/4 of what I'd need lying around, so I thought I'd have a go at making something instead. 100% overkill? Maybe, but I'm in it for pleasure, not profit. I trimmed the box section to length to form an outer case. It was just too big for the vise, so I removed one of the jaws to give me a bit more capacity. Next, I trimmed up a piece of aluminium angle to make a snug-fitting end piece for one end. Then I did the same to make a full width cover for the other end. Then I cut a recess in the bottom of the cover using compressed air to keep the swarf free of the 4mm cutter. I used a slitting saw to create a slot to allow the internal bracket to interlock with the end piece. I repeated the recess milling and slot cutting on the longer end bracket too. This is how the parts fit into the outer cover. One side is left short to leave room for an IEC mains connector, with the cable to the LED panels being clamped in the remaining space. The cable clamp was made from an aluminium block, trimmed to the right height. I drilled it to be a snug fit on the cable, with the actual grip coming from the material that would be lost when the block was split in half. I wanted to groove the inside to improve the clamping, and I thought about putting the forejaw on the lathe, but I abandoned that idea and tapped it M10 instead. The thread would be pretty slobby for a bolt, but I was only interested in the rib surface it gave me. I drilled and tapped a couple of holes to hold the clamp together, then split the block in two. I fitted a couple of temporary screws to test the grip. Happy with the result, I attached the clamp with countersunk screws. I added the cable entry hole and fitted a grommet. After marking out, I drilled and tapped the outer case for a retaining screw. The IEC connector was just a fraction too big, so I took about 0.1 off each side. Here I made up the fixing bracket for the other side of the IEC connector. Next I drilled the outer case and right through the inner bracket to take the switches. By this stage I was beginning to wish I'd bought a box after all. At last, I could fit the switches. And then the 12-way cable, and then I could start wiring up. Finally, the thing was nearly finished. A fair bit of soldering followed as all 8 switches were wired up. After fitting the fuse, the outer cover could be fitted. All that remained was to fit the lights to the shelf and start using it. So that was it, job done. This next bit is a bit of a heads up for anyone who fancies getting some LED light panels themselves. Fairly early on in the project, I decided I liked the LED light. The good colour temperature, low flicker and cool running made me think they'd be handy around the workshop, so I ordered a couple more. Same seller, same listing, same price. It turns out not all lights are created equal. When they arrived, they had different packaging, they were a different panel, and most importantly, they had a different power supply. The originals had good regulation. The new ones had about 8 volts of 100Hz ripple on, which produced noticeable flicker on the camera. A 2200 mic cap across the output brought the ripple down by a factor of 10, though it looks pretty Heath Robinson spatched on the back of the panel. I knocked up a couple of quick brackets and tapped a quarter UNC thread to give me a versatile tripod mount. One panel now lives on the end of a magic arm. And the other on a magnetic DTI base. And that really is it. I hope you found something in there helpful or useful. In any case, thanks for watching. I hope to see you next time.